Commission, Avyaktam Murli, 18th January 2004, 21st. When you become image of success, souls will attain the success of being fully satisfied. Now celebrate the ceremony of the success of every thought and every movement. Celebrate this ceremony. All ways should now end, because when you become images of success, souls will attain the success of being fully satisfied. From being hopeless, the lamps of pure hopes will ignite everywhere. When there is any type of success, they ignite lamp, do they not? Now ignite the lamp of hope in the world. Every soul has one other type of hopelessness. Because of hopelessness, they are distressed and in tension. Therefore, O imperishable lamps, now celebrate the Diwali of the lamps of hope. First the self and then everyone. Did you hear that? So this is the Murli of 18th January 2004. Baba is telling, from being hopeless, the lamps of pure hopes will ignite everywhere. When there is any type of success, they ignite lamp. Now ignite the lamp of hope in the world. Every soul has one or other type of hopelessness. Because of hopelessness, they are distressed, they are in tension. Every soul is hopeless. Every soul is hopeless. In what way? In what manner? And what we have to do? We have to ignite the lamp of hope in the world. This is our task, to ignite hope. When we see that the situation is entirely hopeless, our task is to create hope. And Baba is telling, every soul is hopeless. Yesterday in our OPD, one small girl had come, about 12 years of age. Her parents had brought her, and she was continuously crying. She had fever few days back, now there is no fever, but she was crying continuously, non-stop. Why? Because earlier, few months back, she used to study in some other place, Shivganj, which is near about. Now she has come to Mount Abu and she got admission in Sophia school. So she is finding it so difficult. Earlier it was Hindi medium, now it's English medium. So she is stressed just because of her studies, just because of her exams, everything. She was crying, she has stopped talking with others. Absolutely depressed, just a girl of 12 years of age. If you search depression in the world, you will find in all ages nowadays. And it can be in any field. In this case, it is about career, it's about education. You search everything. Search the field of politics, religion, science. All young people, for that matter, they all are somewhere hopeless for some or other reason. Some or other reason, there is a deep abysmal sense of hopelessness, which is totally corroding their spirits. Why this hopelessness? Because they don't see. If you just take the example of career, recently one of our junior doctor had received a call early in the morning. His friend who was in Surat, who is doing MD second year, who is already a PG student doing MD second year, he called up in the morning and said that he is not feeling like to do anything. He is feeling depressed. So our doctor told that his friend, why don't you come to Mount Abu for some days, or why don't you go home for some days? Like that he told. But he didn't know that this is going to be so serious. In the evening, that PG student, DN, that student, MD student, hung himself in hostel and he died. What a sense of frustration there must be inside. What a deep sense of frustration, what a profound depression which remained undetected. Parents do not know. But he died. There is an utter hopelessness in the world. Even if they get marks, parents are not happy because their parents want that their children should secure more marks. There is another sense of hopelessness, unhappiness, depression. Everywhere, every field, right from students to all the college students, they are caught up in that small love affairs and are taking extreme decisions. Coming to the world of religion, if you study all the religions, there is such a sense of frustration in all the religions, such a sense of hopelessness. If you go to every different institution in the world, religious institutions, spiritual organizations. There is a fight inside. Outside everything is good. Outside they are giving discourses, they are organizing programs. But if you go inside, there is fight, brawl, or some or other petty issues. Somebody is writing book, and the junior monks who are there, junior sannyasis, they feel that we are not given chance. I remember I had received one letter long back when I had decided to renounce this world. One sannyasi had written me. 6 letters I had received many years back before coming in this knowledge, when I decided that I don't want this world. 6 letters, each letter was about 5 to 6 pages. And one sannyasi was writing his history. He was telling, please do not come here. Please do not become like us, because I am absolutely frustrated. I am suffering from HIV, AIDS. I used to write articles, but they used to publish in their names. So much frustration he had written. I was shocked, appalled to see all that things. Such a intense sense of depression and frustration in these sannyasis who had renounced the world, and they are living only for the sake of sadhana, but still so much frustration. So frustration regarding power, frustration regarding their own career, everything in the spiritual life, not in the worldly life, in the spiritual life. Go to the world of politics. All are at loggerheads with each other. All are fighting with each other. Outside they give good speeches, but inside deep frustration. Go to the world of this film, tinsel world, Hollywood and Bollywood. Outside everything is so good, but inside, just study their lives. Each life you study, you will find such hopelessness inside. Because whatever they do, everything, to handle the stardom is not a joke. To handle that much fame, because everything they do becomes a part of social media. Then that social media trolling and so many things start. So, study these people. You will find the same thing. So long as you are working, people recognize you. I was reading once an interview of a film director. He was a film actor. He was saying that, earlier I used to work 20 different films I used to shoot in a day. That time I was very famous. Now I don't do that. So people don't recognize me. That time, in this film industry, if you work, people recognize you. You keep on working whole day from dawn till dusk. People recognize you, otherwise nobody recognizes you. So there is a gnawing frustration there in the film. Come to the world of science. Study all those scientists. One scientist has written somewhere in his autobiography, I have spent my life in atoms and molecules. He has written, I have spent my life in atoms and molecules. Now towards the fag end of my life, I find that life has slipped through my fingers. I didn't do. There is a spiritual vacuum which is created. Something is there which they want and they couldn't do. They feel that something is missing. That missing dimension is self-talk, spirituality, which is not there. So there is a hopelessness in science, in films, in politics, in world of religions. Everywhere outside the world, if you see, it's a harrowing and horrible tale of everyone. What Baba is telling us, to ignite the lamp of hope. To ignite the lamp of hope. We have to become hope for this world. And spirituality is the only hope. Sunday's movie, Baba said, East is getting attracted towards West. They are renouncing those facilities of happiness, those temporary happiness, and these people are seizing and adopting them, utilizing them for themselves. This is what the state of the affair at present. They are lost in sensuality, in materialism. And the more person becomes sensual and more material, the more frustration arises. It's a vicious cycle. We seek all these things to make us happy, but they never make us happy. This realization that this materialism is never going to give me deep and true happiness. So, once somewhere in some class I had heard, The only purpose for reading newspaper is to see what is the Ravan's planning in this world. What is happening in this world? To see the utter hopelessness. To see the utter depression. Because in spite of the fact that we have become a part of this yajna, part and parcel of this yajna, yajna is everything for us, still the world pulls the outside world. The outside entertainment. All the TV channels, serials, movies, they keep on pulling Brahmin mind. As sister was telling, there is little suppression or repression somewhere. It is not the question of repression, it is the question of expression, but positive expression. We are not here to do fast, but to feast. We are not to renounce, but to rejoice. That is our life. So, study hopelessness. For the reason to keep ourselves detached. And then, how do we ignite the lamp of hope? First of all, we have to fill ourselves with that positive attitude. This is the state of the world. It is absolutely negative. But now what I have to do? I have to send vibrations to everyone. People come to us for spiritual questions. But gradually they deteriorate from that stage to their material questions. They start asking all the material questions. My son is not studying, what should I do? My daughter is not getting married, what should I do? BKs. What will happen to her? My daughter is in center, she is not happy. That's why I am not happy. So many mothers. These all things are there in this Brahmin family also. What's happened? This is also family, that is also family. So all those things that happen there will happen here also. No matter how much spiritualized you have become. That doesn't change the course of things. It will be there. But now what we have to do is to ignite the lamp of hope. For that we have to fill ourselves with that hope. Otherwise it is not possible. The way is to get detached and then give sakash. If you are attached, you cannot give sakash. Without vairag, sakash giving is not possible. The person whom you want to give sakash, whom you want to uplift, first step is to get detached from them. People want to stay amidst them, mentally, emotionally bound, and want to help them. It's not possible. First you help yourself. First get detached and then give sakash. Spread ignite the lamp of hope. And that hope will arise only with spirituality. That hope will arise only with Tivra Purushartha. That hope will arise only with practice of spiritual drill. That hope will arise only when these people understand this knowledge. And the Brahmins go into the depth of Murli, do churning, have that unbroken link with Baba. Yesterday Baba told in the Murli, just narrate him all the news. So that you remain connected with him. The moment you get disconnected with him, you are lost. Entire spirituality is about to be connected, to remain connected with Baba. That is the crux of spirituality. The moment this link is snapped, you are out. Then Manmat and Parmat start. So do something that you keep on talking with him. You keep on narrating with him. Baba tells to give chart at night. But I feel that we should give chart twice. Once in the evening. Once you finish your day's work, sit and narrate him everything, whatever that happened, what time you got up. It's sort of you are narrating, not the yad chart of remembrance, but this is just narration. I got up at this time, then I heard Murli, then I heard class, then I went here, then I met this person. You are just giving him an account of what you have done. Now tell if you think anything is wrong. Then I should change. I met a... That helps in clearing the mind. Because so many things are getting clogged there in the mind. We don't know so many things are happening, but we are not revising them. Revise your dincharya. Revise your whatever that has happened in the day. Tell him, this is what happened till now. I am here. Till now, everything is alright. Give a chart at 6 o'clock. Before you begin your evening Namasham yoga. Before you start your evening yoga or meditation, give the chart and then start the evening meditation. And then night is different. Before sleep, then you, whatever, whatever you do, whether you read Murli or whether you have a word with him. But keep the mind clear. Otherwise, 100 things happen in a day. And we don't think of them. And mistakes we do, and we commit the same mistake again. So, we don't want that. Having clarity, whole yesterday's entire Murli was about giving news. What you are doing, now you have come to Madhuban, give this news. Baba, I have come to Madhuban. What you have to do there, make a planning here now. What you have to do at center, what you have to do at home, what you have to do in office, what you have to do about those relationships, make a planning here while still Madhuban. So that we become more and more clear and we remove the hopelessness which is encompassing.